Some women in the southern Mozambique was baking in the village, and they were singing, 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 so much passionate, but they were singing in the local language. I asked for translation. They translated that they were saying, "This is a miracle. We are really making cake in the village." My name is Maria Andrade. I work for the International Potato Center. I'm a sweet potato breeder, and I'm based in Mozambique. I got into sweet potato because when I finished my master program, there was no program on root crops. I met somebody in the University of Arizona who was finishing his PhD in cassava, who could come to Cape Verde as a consultant. We created a 10-year program that I would be able to follow. During this process, I learned cassava, but my passion for sweet potato was just so great. There was this position in Mozambique, advertised by IITA. I applied and I got it, and I arrived in Mozambique in July of 1996. It was by then that we find out, together with the laureate Jan Lowe, that the indicators for nutrition was very, very bad. 69% of children were deficient in vitamin A. The UNICEF was distributing supplementation of vitamin A, but very few children had access to this vitamin A because they were deep in the district. And we remember that sweet potato, especially the orange flesh, could sustainably address vitamin A deficiency. I started introducing the material from all over the place, and Helen Keller International provides some support for me to take this material for adaptive trial in 7 provinces of Mozambique. If we have released that sweet potato without creating a social market strategy, that sweet potato, I would imagine, would be lost in the system. So we create a woman's skirt with the message, and we diversify the utilization because those women could only boil and roast sweet potato. We start training, making flyers, bringing message, radio programs, a theater in the village, and all that. All with the brand Orange. And our logo was the sweet that gives health. Towards the end of that program, we distribute sweet potato planting material for over 1 million farmers. We released the sweet potato, Orange Flesh, in December 1999. In the year 2000, we had the major flood in Mozambique. Sweet potato, during that period of the year, is grown in the lowland. The flood comes to the lowland, and all the sweet potato that is grown there, it disappears. Then we took this opportunity to replace those sweet potatoes, which was white flesh, for orange flesh. This was a catastrophe, but we took advantage of a catastrophe to make some developmental work. In 2005, a major drought came. Some of our material could not resist because of the drought. It was then we realized we need to have our own breeding program in Mozambique to serve Mozambique with a spillover effect in the neighboring countries. In 4 years, we released 15 drought-tolerant varieties. They are being tested in different countries in Africa, and they say, "This is very good. We are also to release this variety." I feel so proud because I have contributed for the objective as a breeder, which is release the variety that people who need to use it are using. The message that we managed to put in Mozambique of the sweet that give health, this sweet potato has a vitamin A, it's also very gratifying.